I'm Donald Heidkamp, and I'm living at 729 Cortland Avenue in Park Ridge, Illinois. Emil was dead as maybe before I was born. I never knew him, but Rose I knew in that, and the thing I remember, two things. When she had, I'm pretty sure it was cousin Phil Heidkamp, George Heidkamp, Dick and me over to her house for an overnight once. And that text her beyond all means. She had a little ringing bell, that an old-fashioned dinner bell with chimes around the center of a ball hung on a string. And we thought that was so great. We kept doing it until it broke. My mother lived down the street. She is a Cunningham. And my Cunningham uncles and my Heidkamp uncles were very good friends. They palled around, and I always thought that I couldn't understand why most families didn't have both sets of uncles such good friends. My dad always claimed the reason he married Catherine Cunningham was he lost in a card game to the Cunningham boys and had to. So that was what caused my mother no end of grief. But a story at that time, my uncle Walter Cunningham and Herb Heidkamp were at DePaul together, and they were good singers, and they were in a chorus at DePaul. And this would be like probably 1915 or 16, the story goes, and they were in the chorus. And one summer, they rode the Atchison, Topeka, and the Santa Fe past all the Hardy Girl restaurants. And at night, they would entertain the Hardy Girls with their choir. And then go on to the next town for the next day. So that was the interplay between the families. They were always very close. The other thing is politics. My dad was so pro-Roosevelt. It was it just exuded from his bones. And so that's why even to today, my brother and I are very liberal Democrats, and most of the family has been. And my father and my Uncle Walter would argue politics until there was no tomorrow. And I thought for a long time, I thought that their friendship would break. But no, it was just they, but they would rant and rave and, how could you be for Roosevelt? Well, how could you be against the mother? So anyway, that was part of it. But then encouraged us to be active. And so my brother and I have been active. We did voter registration. We've been active in the peace movement. Family on both sides had the privilege of being very well educated. Even before, you know, before it was common. I can remember my dad, I got 1912. Graduated from University of Illinois with an engineering degree, and my mother graduated from the DePaul Academy, which was only boys for most years, but at the beginning. And then they formed the great club of the 10 women, the 10 girls, Dace and Puelli, in grammar school at Queen of Angels. See, the Cunninghams and the Heidkamps went to Queen of Angels because they lived in the same parish. So my mother and Aunt Mary Toner were in the same class, and they were two of the 10 girls that formed a club that lasted for maybe 40, 50 years. Dick and I were never musically inclined. In grammar school, we were put in the row of the bluebirds and told not to sing on most songs. And when Sister Jalita, our music nun, broke her hip and couldn't, when the harmonium, where she had to pedal it, was brought into the room for music, and she couldn't pedal because of a bad hip. They asked us to get down there and pump the pedals for her, because we didn't have to sing. So that was the bad side. My mother tolerated Liederkranz cheese. My dad, I don't know where he got from his family, I suppose, the super smelliest, pretty sure it's Liederkranz that was so bad, that he had to put it on the the attic steps. He couldn't put it in the refrigerator, and so that was one of his things. My dad, just for self-protection with us kids, He loved Fig Newton cookies. And we finally figured out the reason he did. None of the kids liked them, so he could eat them all. So he had his own cookies. But the one family thing we have, and I still have some up in my freezer right now, is we had moose tripen, the sausage from Luxembourg and parts of Germany. And we've had that, was a sort of a Christmas tradition that I still keep up, but most of the kids can't stand the smell and taste of it. I remember when Uncle Paul and Aunt Seal got married. And my brother and I must have been 6 or 7, and we went to the reception, which was held in their apartment. And it was Ainsley or one of the local streets near Queen of Angels Church. My dad and mom celebrated their 25th wedding anniversary. It was an all-day party. It started with mass, and then we had breakfast. And my dad had built an upright, large grill outside, not just a funnel, but with a chimney and that. And out of bricks we had stolen from local construction projects. And it took them a while to build it, but then it was really a piece of work. And we have some pictures of it. There's a picture with the four brothers standing around singing. And everybody was there, you know, so the Heidkamps always enjoyed a good party, as did the Cunninghams. So it was that was a big day, a very memorable day. One of the things that my brother and I did when we were priests, we used to say mass at the beginning of a picnic, and that was a big deal because it was the only time a lot of people went to church. It was maybe the last time that year they went to church, if they did. And but it was always very respectfully received. And my father was very neutral. You know, went to church every Sunday and wasn't ushering that. But my mother was quite religious, and she came from a family that was much more religious than the Heidkamps, the Cunningham, and her brother. Older brother became a priest in Minnesota, and I'm named after him. He was Donald Cunningham, and so we just worshipped him from our earliest days. And so both Dick and I never wanted to be a fireman or a race car driver or anything. We wanted to be a priest like Uncle Donald. I met Marsha at a wine and cheese party, and she was a former nun, and two other former nuns listed all the men they knew and invited them to this party in hope of making some connection. And the rest is history. We became good friends, and then we decided to get married. Well, our courtship was I was still very active as the parish priest on the near south side. She was the principal in Pilsen at a school in the Hispanic community there at St. Pius V, where she was principal. And so we frequently would meet for coffee or something after school. After her school day, we'd meet, I can remember, back then you could drive around the planetarium, and there was a parking spaces on the lakeside of the planetarium. We'd meet there, or Connie's Pizzeria, or different places, and so. Most heartbreaking thing was telling my mother. Now, luckily, my sister, the nun, was in town. She was teaching at college at that time, teaching radiology at Moraine Valley, I believe. And so I arranged, she was at dinner with just my mother and me. And when I told my mother, she put her head down and said, didn't say anything, just, and then my sister said, "Ah, what are you feeling?" And she said, "I guess I was too proud having two priest sons." That just hit, I still, staffs, but she and Marcia became good friends, and so the family has always been very, very accepting. Well, we had children maybe 14 months after we were married. Beth was born June 30th, 1974. Danny was born July 1st, 1976. And Mary Helen was born September 9th, 1979.